Hare Krishna. Some people get many insights from one sight, and some not even one insight from many sights. We all go through the world perceiving and processing. And what we perceive and what we process determines what we pursue and what we achieve. So broadly, Krishna says in the Bhagavad-Gita that there are two kinds of people. In 16.6, it said, Dvau bhuta sargau lokesmin daiva asura evacha. So there are the godly and the ungodly, the divine and the demoniac. And essentially, the difference is that how they process and what they pursue. We all perceive many things in life, but after that, what we process and what we pursue is very important. That means if we consider some people just get one sight, they may see one person dying, and then that may make them register within them very deeply the mortality of their existence, and they may start thinking what really matters in life, what counts. And then that can give them a series of insights which can make them deeply philosophical, spiritual, and more centered around the important things of life. But some people might see death regularly. In fact, they might even inflict death regularly because they are violent, they are brutal. But somehow, although they know they themselves are going to die, but still they keep craving and slaving for worldly things. They don't think that, oh, if everybody is going to die, I'm going to die, then why am I slaving so much to get some things which I'll have to leave anyway? So even from many sides, they don't get any insight. So insight is, we could say, the inside sight. That means it is can have two meanings. One is that whatever sight we have, we go inside it to see what it means. And insight can also mean the sight that we have inside us. There is a sight that we have, the power of sight that is there through our eyes. But it is our inner vision that needs to be developed so that we can have a penetrating vision outside to see beyond appearance to substance. And some people just don't have that. That's because they have numb their inner faculties by repeated sensuality. In the Bhagavad Gita in 15.11, Krishna states that some people can yatanto apyakritatmano nainam pashyanti chetasaha achetasaha, those whose consciousness is misdirected, that they just can't perceive anything higher or spiritual because they're deluded by their worldly desires, which come as waves and prevent them from seeing anything higher. Pashyanti yogina. But the yogis, they can perceive higher realities because they have situated themselves in transcendence. So our perception and our realization depend on our overall disposition, on our value system. So the Bhagavad Gita can help us to spiritualize our value system, and then as we start living according to the Bhagavad Gita, living will become a constant process of learning, where through every sight we will get many, many insights and will progress toward the life of meaning and fulfillment. Thank you. Hare Krishna.